Friedrich Hegel was a 19th century German philosopher who devised a particular dialectic or method of argument for resolving disagreements. This dialectic is usually presented in three dialectical stages of development. First is the thesis or problem. At this stage, a crisis is manufactured by the powers that be in order to manipulate the masses, usually by inflicting some sort of physical and or emotional trauma upon the masses.
The breaking news, new reports about the casualties in that shooting at the Sandy Hook Elementary School in Newtown, Connecticut.
Bobby Parker, I assume he's going to come out to the microphones now and make a statement. Looks like the family is there, and they're getting ready to make to come to the microphone, so we'll listen in. Okay. My name is Robbie Parker.
In the hard days to come, that community needs us to be at our best as Americans, and I will do everything in my power as president to help.
Emotional trauma or psychological trauma is a type of damage to the psyche or soul and emotions that occurs as a result of a traumatic event. This trauma may affect the person's ability to cope with stress. Traumatic events that endure or that are repeated can completely overwhelm an individual's ability to cope or integrate the ideas and emotions involved with that experience. The sense of being overwhelmed can cause fear, anger, outrage, and resentment. And through the emotions generated by the trauma, an individual or society as a whole can be set on course to be guided into accepting a predetermined solution. This manufactured crisis gives rise to the second step, which is antithesis or reaction. This comes in the form of public outcry, whereby the public demands a solution to the manufactured crisis.
Her life was cut short. She had so much potential, and you know, it's senseless that her life and Adam's life were taken by a crazy person with a gun. And you know, if I have to be the John Walsh of gun control, and you know, I'm for the Second Amendment, but there has to be a way to force politicians that are cowards and in the pockets of the NRA to come to grips and make sense, have sensible laws so that crazy people can't get guns.
A question that I would like to ask you is how on earth could he compile 13 guns? How can that happen? You know, they talk about gun laws, they talk about gun control. Every time something like this happens, they talk about it and nothing is done. I'm not trying to say that that's the blame for what happened, but if Chris had not been able to get a hold of 13 guns, it wouldn't have happened.
I've had to make statements like this too many times. Communities like this have had to endure tragedies like this too many times.
On Friday, October 2nd, LeBron James spoke out about gun control. He said, obviously, it is not the first time that it has happened, but it's been happening a little bit too much recently. There's no room for guns, first of all, but then for violence towards kids or anybody. He went on to say, it's also the whole nation that goes through this as well. We all hurt from it. Obviously, you're not going to be able to take every gun out. I don't know how you can do that, he continued. There's so many around now today, but if there's some stipulations behind it, or some penalties, some big time penalties or rules or regulations about carrying firearms, legal or illegal, people will second guess themselves. This is a very hypocritical stance for LeBron James to take, especially when he was filmed shooting a military grade weapon. This then leads to the third step of the dialectic, which is synthesis or solution. In this step, the manufactured crisis has caused the intended emotional reaction or response of outrage, fear, and anger from the public. This in turn causes them to clamor for the predetermined solution offered by those who created the crisis in the first place. October 1st, 2015, at least 10 people were killed and 7 others were injured when a gunman opened fire Thursday morning on the campus of Umpqua Community College.
Witnesses are saying the gunman in Thursday's mass shooting in Oregon asked students to state their religion before shooting them.
We have seen these shootings play out across the nation time and time again. If we look at the numbers from the year 2000 to the present, we see a sharp increase in the number of shooting events during this time. In the year 2000, there was one mass shooting. In 2010, there were 26, and in 2013, there were 17. 486 people were killed in 160 active shooter incidents that occurred between 2000 and 2013, with an upward trend during that time period. The vast majority of these shootings, 70% of which, occurred in businesses or schools. Why the sudden uptick in random mass shootings? Because there is an agenda behind the shootings being promulgated by the media, which is the implementation of strict gun control laws, resulting in the eventual and total confiscation of guns from American citizens. These orchestrated mass shootings serve as the thesis or problem used to manipulate the masses by inflicting physical and emotional trauma upon them. The antithesis or reaction then would be the public outcry, whereby the public demands a solution to the manufactured crisis.
My biggest frustration so far is the fact that this society has not been willing to take some basic steps to keep guns out of the hands of people who can do just unbelievable damage. We're the only society, we're the only developed country on earth where this happens, and it happens now once a week, and it's a one-day story. There's no place else like this. A couple of decades ago, Australia had a mass shooting similar to Columbine or Newtown. And Australia just said, well, that's it. We're not seeing that again. And basically imposed very severe, tough gun laws, and they haven't had a mass shooting since.
Notice how the implementation of stricter gun laws or confiscation of guns in other countries was precipitated by mass shootings.
It is not rocket science. Study after study here in the United States and around the world show incontrovertible evidence that where there is more gun control, there are fewer gun deaths. Overseas, the mass killing of school children in the town of Dunblane in the UK in 1996 brought swift new gun control that's dramatically reduced fatalities. And after 35 people were killed in Australia that same year, the newly elected Conservative Prime Minister John Howard went to the country to appeal for and to ram through changes, and there's not been a mass shooting in Australia since.
The synthesis or solution in this dialectic would be the implementation of the predetermined solution offered by those who created the crisis in the first place, or in other words, the coming confiscation of guns in America.
Governor Cuomo said he will consider all options when it comes to gun control legislation, including confiscation. Listen to this.
Well, you could say, well, confiscation could be an option, right?
Yeah.
Sale.
We've never done that before, right. I don't think.
Mandatory sale to the state could be an option.
That's a form of confiscation. Right.
The promotion of gun control is also parroted by the Illuminati-controlled entertainment industry as well.
Now, that said, I'm all for your Second Amendment rights. I think you should be able to have guns. It's in your constitution. What I am not for is arguments and lies. There is one argument and one argument alone for having a gun, and this is the argument. I like guns. It's not the best argument, but it's all you've got. And there's nothing wrong with it. There's nothing wrong with saying, I like something, don't take it away from me, but don't give me this other. The main one is, I need it for protection. I need to protect me, I need to protect my family. Really? Is that why they're called assault rifles? Is it? Never heard of the protection rifles you speak of? Protection? What the f*** are you talking about? You have a gun in your house, mate. You're 80% more likely to use that gun on yourself than to shoot someone else.
It should be noted that Hitler and the Nazi Party instituted gun control legislation in his bid for world domination. This year will go down in history for the first time a civilized nation has full gun registration. Our streets will be safer, our police more efficient, and the world will follow our lead in the future. Adolf Hitler. As we have discussed previously, the Most High teaches us in types and shadows. Hitler was a type of Antichrist, and his gun control was a shadow of the future gun control that will be administered by the Antichrist. It would seem that the Whore of Babylon is deceiving its inhabitants once again. The truth of the matter is, although mass shootings have been covered extensively in the media, mass shootings in reality account for a small fraction of gun-related deaths. Gun violence is most common in poor urban areas and frequently associated with gang violence, often involving male juveniles or young adult males who are black. In fact, the killing of young blacks is an American pandemic. This agenda points to the fact that so-called American blacks are Hebrew captives of Babylon under the curse of Deuteronomy 28. In 2011, the last year for which the FBI has complete data, 1,668 blacks under the age of 22 were killed in this country. That's more than triple the 469 American servicemen and women killed in Afghanistan that year. An average of 8 children was killed each day in 2011, and half of them were black. In 2008 and 2009, black children and teenagers were just 15% of the nation's population, but 45% of young people killed by guns, and as expected, the leading cause of death for black males ages 15 to 19 in those years came from the barrel of a gun. Blacks in this age group were 8 times more likely than whites and 2.5 times more likely than Hispanics to be killed by gunfire.
The main one is, I need it for protection. I need to protect me, I need to protect my family.
So when a comedian says, guns are not for protection, it is obvious that he has never experienced the sobering reality of gun violence for those who live in a black neighborhood filled with guns, drugs, and apathy. And it is obvious his only purpose is to push the New World Order agenda. Even with all the gun violence in the black community, there has never been a push by the media to stem the tide of genocide occurring in neighborhoods which have a Martin Luther King Boulevard as its identifying component. The powers that be are responsible for the influx of narcotics and guns into our communities, and thereby responsible for the gun violence that is a symptom of the genocidal condition which they themselves created. This was proven by Gary Webb, who exposed the connection to the CIA, Danilo Blandon, Iran-Contra, and the cocaine from Nicaraguans that was given to Freeway Rick Ross to sell in the black communities, which resulted in the crack epidemic, apathy, and genocide seen in these communities today.
My name is Gary Webb. I am an investigative journalist. I've been an investigative journalist for about 25 years for daily newspapers. And in 1996, I wrote a series of stories entitled Dark Alliance, which is about CIA involvement in drug trafficking. What my story showed was that the cocaine that was being sold in those neighborhoods was coming from mainly one source. And this one source was being used to finance a guerrilla war in Central America.
Instead of black children who live in these areas being told the truth and provided with a means to overcome the sinister snare or trap that was set up for them before they were born, they are given black entertainers who portray the lifestyle of drug dealers and gangsters. Men who become rich through the exploitation of the system of genocide that exists in their own communities. These black entertainers do so at the expense of the children they influence, while at the same time exposing themselves as puppets of the Masonic Illuminati agenda. This is child sacrifice on a whole other level. Why aren't examples of gun violence in the hood used as examples for the need for stricter gun control laws? Because there is little to no concern for the lives of the people who live in these areas. Therefore, the Hegelian dialectic will not work on the masses if applied to this situation. The point is, America has been a nation of guns since its inception 239 years ago, and random mass shootings historically are a new phenomenon. These manufactured mass shooting events did not occur during the early years of this country as they do now. It should be clear then that the end game of these orchestrated mass shootings is the confiscation of guns, which will facilitate a society which is easily made to bend to the will of its tyrannical dictator, who, incidentally, is the one who gets to keep his guns. Something to think about. Are you scot-free? Shalom.